We're so thankful that you've tuned in today. We're rejoicing in these lessons. We're talking about the love of Christ and how much we are to love one another and how we can live by faith and receive all of the blessings that he wants for us. He says without faith, it's impossible to please God. And for he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and he's the rewarder of those that diligently seek him. So we're going to be rewarded when we get to heaven, because he says in chapter 22 of the book of Revelation, he says, behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me to give every man according as his work shall be. That's why I tell everyone to pray for me, because I don't do this for money. I've served him for over 40 years for the glory of God, because God loves you and I love you, and I want every person to go to heaven. And so does God. It's not his will that any should perish. And hell was made for Satan and his angels. And they are right now where these angels that fell. And see, this is a thing you have today, and this is the only day that you're sure of. And he says, and the angels which kept not their first estate, but left their own habitation, he had reserved in everlasting chains under darkness until the judgment of the great day. And now, if you want to learn something about this enemy that we have and what is happening to the believers today, and people that need to be studying the Word of God and obeying it are being deceived by Satan. And he gives us what he is really like in John chapter 8, verse 44. Now, this is why you have to know the Word of God, or you will be deceived, because Satan is trying to deceive the very elect. He says, ye are of your father the devil, and the lust of your father ye will do. He was a murderer from the beginning, and abode not in the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he speaketh a lie. He speaketh of his own, for he is a liar and the father of it. And because I tell you the truth, you believe me not. This is Christ talking. This is him giving us this warning. And he says, why do you not understand my speech? Even because you cannot hear my word. If you are not born again, you cannot hear his word. You have to have the Spirit of God to be in you. And that Spirit of God takes the Word of God and teaches us when we read this book. And he also does the same thing when we pray. We pray and in what the Word gives to us. And this is one of the greatest things. We began last week with being obedient to him in his love and the commandments that he has given to us. And in Mark 12, 28, this is for every person in the world to know this. One of the scribes came to him, and he says, which is the first commandment of all? And Jesus answered him, the first of all the commandments is, hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord. And thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, with all thy mind, and with all thy strength. And this is the first commandment. And the second is, namely this. Now, every one of us can give every person in this universe this prayer that I prayed in Ephesians chapter 3. That is for all the saints. And we are to do what this book says right now. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. Now you see why that is sound so difficult and say, I can't do it, God doesn't expect us to. He lives this word through us when we believe and give it to Him. You have not because you ask not. Ask and you shall receive, that your joy may be full. And He says, for there is but one God, and there is none other. He's the only true God that we can worship, deity is. And there is none other commandment greater than these two. This is one of the greatest blessings. And He says, hitherto have you asked nothing in my name. Ask and you shall receive, that your joy may be full. You see, He wants us to live the abundant life. That's what the Word of God is for. And that is John 16:24. And when we obey Him, our lives are completely in perfect peace. Because my Bible verse is, in everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. And if you're not giving thanks, you're not in His will. The trials that we go through are just for a moment compared to eternity in hell. And here He says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. You see, we have a choice, going to heaven or to hell. That's our choice. God never made hell for people. He made hell for the devil and his angels. And this is why we are to do what His Word commands us to do. Now, when we see this and hear it, you say, I can never do that. But He lives this Word through us, and it is no effort of ours. We can receive nothing except it be given to us from heaven, and all things come of Him. Now, I'm going to give you another Bible verse, another Bible prayer that I pray. And I want you to listen to this so you can know and learn it and pray this every day. Because every day we have food for our body. Every day we have food for our spiritual body. This is what He has for us in every word that we give to Him. And when we read this and think of all that He does for us, He says, now this is in 2 Peter chapter 1, and He says, grace and peace be multiplied unto you. That's what I wanted you to hear. Through the knowledge of God and of Jesus our Lord. And then verse 3, according as His divine power hath given unto us all things that pertain to life and godliness, through the knowledge of Him that hath called us to glory and virtue. And I'm going to pray that with you, and I want you to learn it, and pray 1 Chronicles 29 and Ephesians 3 and 4. Your life will change as soon as you give prayer to Him daily, to worship Him in spirit and in truth. Let's pray. Our gracious and dear Heavenly Father, we thank Thee that we can come to the throne of grace to obtain mercy and to find grace to help in time of need. We thank Thee and praise Thee for Thy love for us. If we ask anything in Thy name, Thou wilt do it, that the Father may be glorified in the saints. This is all of us. He wants to do everything. Our Heavenly Father and our deity are one, and we are one in them. As we come to the throne of grace, we first of all praise Him and worship our deity in spirit and in truth, and worship Him in the beauty of Thy holiness, and to offer the sacrifice of praise to Him continually, the fruit of our lips, giving thanks unto Thee. And we see in this lesson, in Peter, 2 Peter, we are to every promise that he's given to us is ours to appropriate by faith. All of his exceeding great and precious promises are ours, and we have his divine nature in us, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust. And besides all of this, add to your faith virtue, and to virtue knowledge, and to knowledge temperance, and temperance patience, and patience godliness, and godliness brotherly kindness, and brotherly kindness love. And if these things be in you and abound, he maketh that we shall neither be barren nor unfruitful in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and we will never fall. Giving thanks unto the Father, which hath made us meet to be partaker of his divine inheritance as saints of light. And we're praying for 100-fold today. Every day we pray for 100-fold. And we're asking even now, this is once again Ephesians chapter 4. Giving thanks unto the Father, this is the most important thing. For the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ, until we all come into the unity of the faith, we must have complete unity. And we thank thee and praise thee for faith in thee. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. So now we're going to go to 1 John. Now remember this second prayer that I prayed is in 2 Peter, and it begins in chapter 1, verse 2 and 3, and then it goes all the way down. And we will never fall. We will never fall. This is the greatest gift in the world. And now we're going to go to 1 John. This is so amazing what we learn in 1 John. This is I have to just think about how many things that I can give to you about John in regular John, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. And I'm going to give you these because they are so important, and I want you to listen. The Gospel of John is a gospel of love. John wrote the book of John, and he is the apostle of love. And I told you before that love is in the 21 chapters of John, 57 times. And his love is everlasting, and it is the word of life. And I gave you Revelation 1:5. He loved us and washed us from our sins in his own blood, and hath made us kings and priests unto God and our Father, Jesus Christ. To him be glory and dominion forever and ever. And Jeremiah 31:3, yea, I have loved thee with an everlasting love, an everlasting love. And in John 15 and 16, we already had that whatsoever you shall ask the Father in my name, he may give it you, if you believe and not doubt. And in John 15, 17, these things I command you, that you love one another. And this is what we learn in these lessons about John and what he has given to us. And you can just do that in a week. Read the book of John, 21 chapters, and 1st, 2nd, and 3rd John. And this is how you learn. And then you want more. When you get into this book, you want to know more about him. Your life changes. So this is what we see now. We saw that we are an heir of God and a joint heir with Jesus Christ. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. In Christ we have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness of sin. By his own blood he entered in once into the holy place. It is the blood that is the very life and power of the Word of God, and his blood is pure and cleanses us from all sin. And you never doubt and you never have fear when you know that you can ask and he will cleanse you from all sin with his divine blood because he never sinned. And then for those of you that have never heard these, this is, you were not redeemed with corruptible things as silver and gold, but with the precious blood of Christ. And this is a very important Bible verse. And this is for every person that has never heard these about, ye are not your own, for you are bought with a price. Therefore glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are his. You see, when we present our bodies a living sacrifice, we don't do what the world does. We live in his perfect will, and we don't need anything but his word to know how to live that. And then he says, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Greater is he that is in you. Greater is he that is in you. Greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. And you see what he says? Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. This is one of the things that I do almost every morning before I get out of bed. Put on the whole armor of God that I may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. And that is the breastplate of righteousness. The shield of faith will quench all the fiery darts of Satan. We are covered with his righteousness. We are covered with the shield to keep us from sinning against a holy God. He does all of that for us every second of every day. And this is what is the greatest thing. I say unto you, love your enemies. We have to know this, and I didn't give you where it was. Matthew 5:44. Bless them that curse you, and do good to them that hate you, and pray for them which despitefully use you and persecute you. And now this is one of the things that is so difficult to understand, but he says in 1 John 1, if we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. We have to continue to obey and confess our sins, and he never remembers them no more. That's the greatest blessing. So why should we have guilt when the blood cleanses us? And then he says, whosoever hateth is a murderer. You see, that's why we can't hate, because that's all from Satan. This is how we turn to the Word of God. We can't live and please God and hate anyone. And he says, you know that no murderer hath eternal life abiding in him. And that is John 3:15. So this is the greatest thing, that we can love our enemy, because he will do it for us. And then when we come to the book of John, he gives us the greatest blessings. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God, and everyone that loveth is born of God and knoweth God. This is 1 John 4:7-8. He that loveth not knoweth not God, for God is love. In this was manifested the love of God toward us, because that God sent his only begotten Son into the world that we might live through him. Every promise he gives us, you can feel the strength that he gives you when you study the Word of God. It's the greatest blessing there is in the whole world. You see, you can't look at man and please God. We are to look at him with all of the many blessings that he has prepared for us. And this is the greatest thing, because he has mansions waiting. The street is pure gold and the city is pure gold. And the gates are a solid pearl. But you see, hell is just the opposite. The blackness of darkness forever. We're children of light. We're not children of darkness now. And you can be that today. And this is why you want to study the Word of God and learn it, so you will never have to go to a place like that, because that is eternal. Heaven is eternal. We will never have pain or sorrow. And if you kill someone, you are a murderer, and you are going to drink the blood of that person when you stand before God. That is in the book of Revelation chapter 16. You see, that's what a murderer has looking forward to. This is not for people. And if you know that, you will change. You will never sin against Him and enjoy it, because that's what He does for us. And then He says, herein is love, not that we love God, but that He loved us and sent His Son to be the sacrifice for our sins. And He also warns of the false teachers. Children warn against the things that are not of God. And the only way you can know that is to study the Word of God and live it. He says, little children, it is the last time. Now, this is a long time ago when this was written. And as you have heard that Antichrist shall come, even now are there many Antichrists, whereby we know that it is the last time. You see, we're to be looking forward to Him, because the Antichrist is going to be reigning for 7 years on this earth. But we're going to be in heaven. We're going to be in heaven. We won't be here. But you know what? The 12 tribes of Israel are going to be teaching the Word of God then. And listen what it says about them. The 12 tribes of Israel are going to be teaching the gospel of the kingdom. And in chapter 14, this is the most amazing story in the world. And I looked, and lo, a lamb stood on Mount Zion, and with him 144,000, having his Father's name written in their foreheads. And I heard a voice from heaven, as the voice of many waters, and the voice of great thunder, and I heard the voice of harpers, and harpers playing the harps, worshiping our deity in heaven. And they sung a new song before the throne, and before the 12 four beasts and the elders, that's all of us, and no man could learn that song but the 144,000 which were redeemed from the earth. These are they which were not defiled with women, for they are virgins. God expects virgins, every person to be a virgin. And they were virgins preaching the Word of God. That's how we're to be today, man and woman. These are they which followed the Lamb wheresoever He goeth. These are redeemed from among the first fruits unto God and to the Lamb. And in their mouth was found no guile, for they are without fault before the throne of God. This is how we're to be. We are to live this. This is the most amazing story. And they could not be touched because they were sealed like we are. You see, when you become a child of God, I don't think I brought it in here, but yes, here it is. Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil, praying always. You see, this is what we are to live like this. And everything that we do is in perfect purity and holiness. And here we see they went out from us, but they were not of us. You see, they pretend to be a Christian, but they love their sin too much to give the sin up. And he says, for if they had been of us, they would no doubt have continued with us, but they went out that they might be made manifest and were not of us. You see, God looks on the heart. This is His attribute. This is the most amazing thing. Now listen at what omniscient means. Every person, you will never, ever do anything that God doesn't already know it. He says in Proverbs 15:3, that is omniscient, means He's all-knowing. The eyes of the Lord are in every place, beholding the evil and the good. Ezekiel 11:5. I know the things that come into your mind, every one of them. You see, our mother taught us that when we were growing up. God looks on the heart. It changes your life. And then he says in Matthew 12:25, and Jesus knew their thoughts. He knows their thoughts today. You see, that is the most amazing thing. And he's omnipotent. He's all-knowing. He's all-powerful. For the Lord God omnipotent reigneth. For the Lord is good, for his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth to all generations. He's all-powerful and all-knowing. You know what? He holds this earth upon nothing. And you know, he knows the number of the stars and calls them all by name. If we could just know how great he is and his love for us. He says, verily, verily, I say unto you, if a man keep my sayings, he shall never die. That is John 8:51. That is enough today to turn to him. And this is what he wants us to see in him every second of every day. Now, I'm just going to show you this. This is the last thing. This is what we're waiting for. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel and the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. We're going to see them that have died coming up with a new body in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye. That's what we're waiting for. We're going to be raptured and meet him in the clouds. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel and the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together to meet them in the clouds, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. You see, here we have this, all of the people that have gone before us. They didn't die. They were absent from the body and present with the Lord. Our spirit and soul go to be with the Lord, and our body goes back to dust. There's nothing in our bodies but dust. And then we will be raptured. If it should be today, here it is. And the world that's left on this earth, they will see us because we're raptured in the book of Revelation, chapter 4. They heard the voice of God saying, come up hither. I'm just waiting for that moment, and I want every person that is listening to this program, every one of you right now, get on your knees and pray and ask God to come into your heart and save you from all sin. He will do it. That's what he's waiting for. And this is my prayer. He says, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. I've set before thee an open door, no man can shut it. He which hath begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. I pray for your salvation every day, the whole world. And he says, blessed, suffer the little children to come unto me and forbid them not, for such is the kingdom of God. That's all his promise to me, and I have lived that. And he is fulfilling it all. And I thank God for every day that I live, every second. 84 years old. I don't take any medicine. I'm never sick. And don't have any pain and never go to the doctor. That's all from him. And I have the most blessed friends in the world. They all pray for me. Thank God for each of you today, and I'll see you in heaven.